Studio 61, powered by Vantage TV by Frontier.
The Hartford Current Travel Show Fall and Winter Escape gets underway on the 21st. And joining us to talk about the mansions in Newport, Rhode Island is John Rodman, the Director of Museum Experience. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. I'm glad to come and sit with you every time.
We always talk to you about this awesome experience because the history of Newport is so unique. I mean, you have families like the Vanderbilts, the Astors, the Morgans. They lived there for, 6 weeks every summer. So you get to see their houses. But there's also some little behind the scenes to share as well. I'll let you go
in. Well, one of the things that we discovered about the Breakers is that the current Breakers was built because the original previous building burned down because of a boiler explosion.
Right.
So when they built the new building, they put the boiler room out front and there's this immense underground tunnel complex. You always knew there was a secret tunnel at the Breakers, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, we've restored it.
It
cost $1 million, but now that boiler room is fully restored, people can see how the wonderful technologies that we think of as our domestic technologies that are part of our homes, the modern bathroom, these things are actually invented for the mansions. And so you have this, all this technology we live with, it's our domestic technology, clothes washers, all of these various things. Where did they originate? Who thought of them? Why?
Right.
Well, that's what this tour tells you about. It's called Beneath the Breakers.
All right. Now, not only are there things to see in each one of the mansions, but there are also things like exhibits that come in. So talk to us a little bit about one that's on its way, or is it already here?
It's already here.
Okay.
Pierre Cardin, and it is a 70-year retrospective. It was personally curated by Mr. Cardin. He's 95. And this is the only place in America that this is showing. It was curated for us. It is at Rosecliff right now, and it'll be there through the end of the year. And it is a remarkable collection of arguably the most exciting things to emerge in the fashion world from the 1960s all the way forward.
Ooh.
And that's at Rosecliff.
Talk about fashion while in Rosecliff. It doesn't really get much better.
And that's part of your regular admission to Rosecliff.
Oh, nice. Very nice. Okay, one other thing that I think is fantastic about the mansions. Can you tell I just love Newport? I still haven't been, and I still to this day say, I need to go. Christmas time in the mansions is something that I heard has been just spectacular, and I need to get there.
You do. The Breakers, Elms, and Marble House, all decorated very fancifully. Now, we know that people, for the most part, in these families, were in New York, they were in Philadelphia, wherever at Christmas. But we know they observed Christmas. We know what Victorian Christmas traditions might be like, what the Christmas traditions in the late 1900s, early 20th century might have been like. And so what we're doing there is we're actually kind of creating a fanciful experience that we admit is not an attempt to recreate the exact family Christmases.
Right.
But all of, for example, we have something like 36 different fireplaces in the houses. A different garden club in the region decorates each mantle. So
wow.
A little bit of competition there.
Yeah.
And then we have a poinsettia tree that is 35 feet tall. In other words, it's a giant wooden frame that is just populated. That's in the Great Hall of the Breakers. It's just amazing. And then Saturday nights, we take down the ropes. We have an open house, refreshments, live music at the Breakers. And then one evening, we set aside the Elms and Marble House, and they're both one admission. Christmas at the Newport Mansions is just absolutely bucket list material. You've got to do it.
I have to do it. John, thank you so much for being with us. We really appreciate
it. Thanks.
Well, we still have a lot.